Hello everyone, this is Anuj from Gadget Kick. Today we have with us the OnePlus Band, which is the first fitness tracker from OnePlus. And in this video, we will do the unboxing and show you the features of this fitness tracker. So let me quickly show you the unboxing experience. So here we have the box, and in the front we have the OnePlus branding along with the picture of the band. And here at the back we have some key features such as SpO2 monitoring, sleep tracking, 24x7 heart rate tracking, 13 exercise mode, dual color sport band design, 1.1 inch AMOLED display, 14 days battery backup, and this band is also 580m waterproof. The MRP on the box is ₹2799, however, it's available to purchase right now at ₹2499, which is same for the Mi Band 5. Now let's open the box and show you the content. So first we have this envelope in which we have the documentation such as the invitation to the Red Cable Club, warranty details and the user guide. And here we have the fitness band itself. My first impression is that it looks very similar to any other fitness tracker in this price range. But the build quality and design looks good, especially this dual color band. We will look at it in a moment, let's see what else we have in the box. So in the box we get this charging cradle, which is similar to the previous versions of Mi Band. And in this, you would need to remove the module from the band like this and place it in the charging dock. To be honest, I never liked this charging method. A magnetic charging cable would have been better. So that's all we have in the box. Now let's look at the tracker closely. OnePlus Band is the company's first fitness tracker. And talking about the design and quality, I really like the build quality of this fitness tracker. The strap feels pretty good and you have the line pattern on the top and a dual tone grey color at the back. OnePlus has also launched two more colors for the band, which you can purchase for ₹399. Now talking about the comfort, this fitness tracker feels lightweight and really comfortable on the hand. The weight of the tracker with the strap is only 22 grams. The display of this fitness tracker is a 1.1 inch AMOLED display, which has a resolution of 126 by 296 pixels. There are no capacitive buttons on this tracker and it's a full touchscreen display. Looking at the back of the tracker, we have the optical heart rate sensor and the blood oxygen sensor. You also get 3-axis accelerometer and the gyroscope. And in other technical details, you get the Bluetooth 5.0 support in this band. And as mentioned earlier, this fitness tracker is IP68 waterproof. Now about the battery backup, you get the 100mAh battery in this band, which company claims can give you up to 14 days of battery backup. Overall, the design and build quality looks very good. And keeping it side by side with the Mi Band 5, you can see they almost look identical. Now let's turn on the smart band and pair it with our phone. In order to turn it on, you will need to remove the module from the band and put it on charging. And now it's on and ready to pair. So the first thing which disappointed me that at the moment there is no iOS support for this band and the OnePlus Health app is only available for Android. So let me get my Android phone. So here is the app and for us, pairing the watch also took some time and for some reason, it wasn't showing us the tracker in the available list. We tried restarting our phone and the tracker and after some time, we were finally able to connect the tracker to our phone. So here it is, the tracker is now paired and ready to use. So let's go through the menu. So for the first time, it will tell you about the gestures and some other features. You can operate this fitness band with only touch and different gestures, which by the way seems very responsive. Now about the features. Here we have the watch face and you can cycle through different watch faces on the tracker by swiping left or right. The tracker can store up to 5 watch faces at a time and you can also install more from the app which I will show you in a moment. So when you touch on the watch face, you get a quick look at some details such as battery, DND status and the Bluetooth connection. Swiping up on the watch face will give you the access to the menu. So first we have here is the daily activity, which shows you your current fitness data such as step count, calories burned and distance traveled. Now to go back, you need to swipe right on the watch face. And then we have the workout menu and here you have 13 workout modes including cricket and swimming. There is no inbuilt GPS in this fitness tracker and it takes the GPS data from your phone. After that we have the heart rate menu and as mentioned earlier, this tracker supports continuous heart rate monitoring. And about the accuracy, we found the heart rate data accurate when compared with the Apple Watch and the Fitbit Versa. After the heart rate, we have the SpO2 monitoring. And again, the data was accurate when we compared it with the standalone SpO2 monitoring device. Then in the menu, we have the sleep tracking, which we haven't tested till now. After that, we have the breathe menu, which allows you to calm yourself down with some breathing exercise. Then we have the weather, and here you have some details about the current day's weather, but no weather forecast. After that we have the tools menu, and here we have music, which allows you to control music on your phone, and you can also increase or decrease the volume. And this band auto shows music control when you play the music on your phone. After music we have stopwatch, timer, which includes some preset timers. And then we have the alarm and the camera shutter control, which also works perfectly. And after that we have the search phone feature, which plays a loud tone on your phone. Now coming back to the main menu, then we have the settings, and here we have the DND settings, brightness, which you need to set manually as there is no auto brightness support. After that we have the screen on time, which you can set up to 10 seconds. Then we have the vibration settings, and then the regular shutdown and the reset option. So that's all the option we have on this band, and guys, I really like the display quality and the touch response on this band. The viewing angles are also good and the visibility is decent for both indoor and outdoor conditions. Now let's look at the app. OnePlus Health app is pretty basic, and here on the homepage you get the fitness data, which includes heart rate, sleep tracking, SpO2 and so on. There is no option to log your weight details as well as some other fitness data. And this app does not support Google Fit integration. Now to access the settings, you need to go to the manage page, and here we have the OnePlus band details. And you can see the remaining battery here. Now below it we have the menu. So first we have the watch store, which has some decent amount of watch faces. You can also apply your own picture as a watch face, which is also good. Then we have the tips menu, which includes touch gestures. And guys, this smart band supports raise to wake feature, which is very responsive. And also, when you cover the screen with your palm, it turns off the display. After that we have the more menu, and here we have the notification settings. And here you can select the apps for which you want the notification on the band. And talking about it, here is how you get the call notification. And in this, you can reject the call or silent the call from the band itself. And here is how you get the message notification. Unfortunately, you can't reply or use preset replies to the notifications. Then in the settings we have the alarm, workout and health settings, which includes your daily fitness goal, continuous heart rate tracking and sleep SpO2 monitoring, which you can set for interval or real time, but it will consume more battery. And lastly about the battery, with the continuous SpO2 and the heart rate monitoring, we noticed 25-30% dip in the battery on the first day, which doesn't look very good. But guys, we also got an update while using the band, and here are the update logs which have some battery optimization. We will be testing this fitness tracker more in the coming few days, and we will also be comparing it side by side with other fitness trackers such as Mi Band 5 and the Honor Band 5. So stay tuned for that. Overall, the OnePlus band looks promising. I really like the build quality and design, and hardware wise, this fitness band looks very good on paper. The display quality and the touch response is also good. However, there are few things which I didn't like about this fitness tracker during my hands-on. First is the companion app. Lack of iOS support is an issue, and even the Android app doesn't look that polished. And to be honest, I wasn't expecting this from OnePlus. The battery backup is not good right now, and even after the update, I can see the battery is draining very fast, but I'll be using it more and will let you know more about the data accuracy and the battery backup in our comparison video. So stay tuned for that. But as of now, I would not recommend this fitness band to anyone, and if you're looking for a fitness band, then go for the Mi Band 5 instead of the OnePlus band. So that's it guys, this was the unboxing and overview of the OnePlus band. Let us know if you like it. And also, do tell us if you have any question about this fitness tracker in the comment section below. So that's all for now. If you like this video, then please press the like button and subscribe to our channel Gadget Geek for more videos like this. Once again, this is Anuj signing off, and I'll see you in the next one.